2019 Chicago Bulls. At power forward, Alize Johnson. At center, Tony Bradley. At point guard, Lonzo Ball. At the other forward position, DeMar DeRozan. At the other guard position, Zach LaVine. The head coach of the visiting team is Billy Donovan.
To remember now, but Joel Embiid did miss his first two seasons due to injuries. He said, "It was rough. Think about what I went through and how it prepared me to be a better man. I really feel like I'm the process, and the process is about me. So every time I step on the court, it's all about having fun. I'm just enjoying my time in the league." Kevin, back to you.
A lot of depth in there, David. Thank you for that. And for a look at how the competition stacks up right now. These, the new power rankings, they tell a great story. Look at Philadelphia. They're still dominant, sitting at number one once again.
And checking out Chicago, they're just right now outperforming those preseason predictions. And that's because they're getting help from some unlikely sources.
Now let's take a look at the Bulls' opening lineup. In the backcourt, it's Ball and LaVine. Johnson is out there with DeRozan. And it's Bradley in at the five spot. And for the 76ers, the stars of this team in the post, Harris and Embiid. Outside the wings are Curry and Green. And it's Russell in at the point. What's the most important thing, Clark, a player has to focus on when it's this early in the season?
Well, I think one is making sure you're in really good shape, and then getting comfortable with your teammates is another element. And getting your chemistry and timing back, those are probably the most important things.
Doesn't go, and he's 0 of 1 from the field. And it's Bradley with the ball for Chicago. LaVine finds Ball. DeRozan, a screen on Russell. Back to LaVine. Outside DeRozan. Diving in. And Embiid with the block. Russell against Ball. Back to Russell. Screen on Ball. It's stolen by Johnson. Oh, here comes Johnson all alone. goes out of bounds. Last touch by Embiid. A fantastic mobile one block. This one deserves another look.
And making a statement right away, letting them know they won't get any easy ones when he's around.
Johnson kicks to DeRozan. Shot off. Great D that time from Green. Harris passes to Dirk. And B with a screen on Levine. Here's Curry. Gonna go that time. Now Chicago takes it the other way. Their last game, a win against Boston, looking to carry it into this one.
And you gotta love a team that can maintain its composure on the road, take good shots, and knock them down with confidence.
Well, efficiency is critical, and I love how they ran their offense and got quality shots out of their sets.
Rocket two. That doesn't go either for DeRozan.
You almost have to assume he's going to knock those down when he is that open.
Curry gets to Harris. A pass to Embiid. Russell with it. Now guarded by Ball. And it's Russell missing.
I wouldn't say that's exactly his spot now. I mean, and you can see why.
I mean, you tend to forget this about Levine. I mean, he's still so young. You feel like he's been in the league forever.
Levine, good.
Zach Levine.
Levine's got the scoreboard going with his first points of the night for the Bulls. Sixers.
Yeah, extremely crafty, smart, clever. Levine with the ball on the string, creating all the separation he needs to do work.
And your Sixers dance team.
The NBA in steals last year. The 76ers number one.
You know, I don't know if the numbers even told the story. I mean, their defense was as good as it gets, often just leaving their opponents completely demoralized.
And just under 2.5 minutes elapsed here in the first. Outside, Green. Pass to Embiid. Shoots over Bradley. Pulled the shot a little up, but the bounce goes his way.
He'll proclaim it himself to you. Within earshot, Embiid's mid-range shot is the key that opens everything up for him.
Now, here's Ball. He had 15 points last hour. DeRozan against Green. Shot clock at six. DeRozan's shot is off.
Putting up a goose egg bagel this period. At this point, you have to run the offense through somebody else. I mean, that's the only choice.
Harris, his shot is good.
There's no way you can minimize his concentration. Excellent focus in finding a way to score that time by Harris.
Passes the ball. He dishes it to DeRozan. Brown. Bradley, a screen on Cook. Levine gets to DeRozan. The Bulls need to get a shot off here. Ball, no good. And Embiid has got the ball here for the Philadelphia 76ers. Fresh from a win against Portland.
Yeah, and that one, they just locked it down defensively. Challenge shots and really protected the rim.
Boy, I tell you what, I think you got to really appreciate the grit, getting dirty, staying engaged. That's really what defense is all about.
And flying high and walking it down with the one hand.
One of his favorite moves right there, guys.
Does it as well as anybody, fellas. Tremendous skill while in the air.
Now here's Levine. Bradley sets the pitch for ball. And Collins lines it in.
And felt that instant response. Don't try to throw down on his team. It just gets them fired up.
And that's the result. They launch an assault on the basket.
I think the stakes just gotten raised a little bit.
Russell, no good.
Those are chances. Almost always you can rely on him to get you 2 points, but the D just enough to keep him out of rhythm.
Now here's Levine, coming off a stellar performance against Boston. Ball dishes to DeRozan. Levine with it. He's picked up by Russell. And Embiid with the block.
He is such a well-coordinated, fluid athlete for his shot. A lot of shots, and probably changes even more.
Russell against DeRozan. Pass to Harris. Some nice ball movement here by the 76ers. There's Embiid. Score it. His third free basket in 3 tries.
A precision passer, Curry, also excellent seeing his guys when they're open.
They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've gone a long time without a bucket.
Bradley kicks the ball. Curry against DeRozan. Gets that one to drop. First one of the game after 4 straight misses.
Well, guys, I look at DeMar DeRozan, and I think he's one of the very best at making tough shots. I mean, the defense is draped all over him, and he still finds a way to get it up and down.
Now here's Embiid. He picked up 12 points in their last one against Portland.
And how about the block shots, guys?
Sixers ball. Substitution for the
76ers.
And the 76ers with some changes. Andre Drummond's checked in for Joel Embiid. Matisse Thybulle comes in for Danny Green. And Maxey subbed in for Seth Curry. Russell against Ball. 6 on the shot clock. Here's Harris. Another shot. And it's Drummond missing.
Well, you have to like their work on the boards, Kevin, particularly here to start the game.
Yeah, I like the way they're setting the tone. Really playing with a lot of energy here at the start.
Russell looking around. And Andre Drummond, a bucket on the assist by Russell.
That's where Drummond generates most of his offense. I mean, he's got a lot of moves in the low post.
I'm out for the ball.
All right, fans, on your feet, make some noise. Come on, let's get it. All right, coming up to the ball right now, the Trip Sixers and Kings.
is making a change here. Nope, he's checked in. So Chicago going with an almost entirely new group. Williams, he's checked in for Johnson. Jones comes in for DeMar DeRozan. White, he's checked in for Zach LaVine. And it's Alex Caruso in for Lonzo Ball. Here's Caruso. Now the pass to White. And it's sent back by Drummond.
You got to be careful shooting around Drummond. I mean, he has a really good knack for when to go for the blocks.
Bulls trail by four. And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Tyrese Maxey. That's his first foul.
Personal foul. First team foul.
Here's Bradley. 11 points for him in that last game against the Celtics in Boston. Williams has a screen for White.
Boy, outstanding hustle from Harris on the defensive end. They're doing a good job to off the shots with that activity.
And with Kobe White, you hate to see him settle. He's best when going at the rim. The defense wins if he takes that mid-range jumper.
Drummond, the screen. Milton with it. Now guarded by Brown. And Drummond throws it down.
They need a bucket in a big way here to regain some confidence.
Outside Williams. White setting the pick for Williams. Going inside. And Williams with the stuff.
You know, didn't need two hands for that slam. Do just fine.
You're right. He can save the other hand for the next time.
Yeah, I like the variety, though. Nice to switch it up.
Now, here's Milton. He's been patient so far. Nothing on the scoreboard yet. Inside. Deflects the pass. Good for the basket. Starting off 1-for-1 with that shot. And Greg with Kobe White. He's a solid shooter. The teams have keyed in on
him. I just want to see him more in attack, though. He's a solid finisher when he gets in there. And it could take his game to the next level.
Now, here's Brent. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Williams outside. Brooks has the 24-second shot clock violation, so he'll turn it over.
8 in assists. 9 in field goal percentage.
And they were in the top half of the league in terms of rebounding. They weren't going to win the rebounding battle, but every night it gave them a chance to compete.
And this, as you talked about, there weren't many teams in the NBA that focused as much on passing as they did. Sure, the offense included all 5 guys on the floor. Drummond with a screen on Williams. And dunk by Harris.
That's 7 for the layup. Sometimes you got to go strong, and Harris gets the chance to stuff it there. He didn't let it slip by him.
Caruso looking for an opening. On the wing, Williams. Guarded by Harris. Williams passes to White. Back to Williams. Bradley sets the pick for Williams. Jacks up a 3. And a good pick.
What a block from Harris. Terrific work there.
Sixers ball.
Philadelphia leading by 8. Here's Max. He's been quiet so far. Still no points in the game. Harris with it. Williams picks him up. A shot by Milton, no good. Chicago's gone 0-3 from 3-point land. Nothing yet going outside. And White kicks to Caruso. Dishes it to Jones. Outside, White. Back to Jones. Just 4 to shoot. Rebound Andre Drummond. Drummond's got 4 rebounds in this game. Pass to Maxey. The dish to Drummond. Spins. Shoots from the elbow. Maxey, no good. And Caruso's got the ball here for the Chicago Bulls. points. Trailing here by 8. And guys, this is the first they're seeing of the 76ers this year.
In this game, just the first of 4 meetings between these two. They'll get quite familiar with each other by season 0.
I get the feeling that this could be an interesting matchup this season. This first game will tell us a lot.
Bulls trail by 10. Time called here. The Bulls decide to talk it over.
Trying to find some answers offensively.
Yeah, and you know, that's going to be the focus of this timeout. They need to come up with a spark to get the offense going.
All right, calling out to the court right now is your Sixers dead team.
Assists, and his rebounding is what's most impressive. He's shown tremendous determination on the backboard.
And it's a big asset for this team. I mean, he blocks out on the defensive glass, and then he keeps balls alive at the offensive end.
Here's Caruso, still getting warmed up offensively. No scoring yet from him. Right finds William. 6 to shoot. Here's Caruso. Off the mark, and the drop continues. The 76ers leading by 10. There is a screen. Maxey passes to Harris. And slam dunk by Harris.
Their play on both ends has been superb. We'll see if they can maintain it.
And you know, nothing like getting an opponent on the ropes early. You love that. On that side of the scoreboard, and they are landing some haymakers now.
That shot misses. Good work defensively by Jones. Now 8 seconds separating the two clocks. Here's Caruso, defended by Thibault. Outside, White. Rebound Andre Drummond. Drummond's got 6 rebounds here tonight. Here's Harris. No good on that one. And so it's the Philadelphia 76ers enjoying a 12-point lead as they talk things over during the break. They've been putting on a clinic in the paint. Shots are falling with regularity, and they are pounding it down low. We'll take a quick break and then back to the action here.
To, you know, be more aggressive, you know, just look to impose myself, just look to dominate. I guess I need to go back to having fun and just dominate. And
certainly Embiid has shown he can dominate.
MVP level talent. He's just got to bring it every time down the floor.
And so far through one quarter, it's been a lopsided game. We'll see if that changes here in the second. And the 76ers have been rolling along, haven't they?
It's just
what
going so.
In that first quarter, they're doing their matchups defensively.
Yeah, I agree. I mean, look at the energy, the effort defensively. They put it all out there in that opening quarter.
And now, brought to you by Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go. It's Lou Center lineups. So for Chicago right now, in the backcourt, it's Ball and Levine. DeRozan out there with Johnson. And it's Jones in at the center position. Levine passes to DeRozan. A floater, and he sinks the layup.
Mar DeRozan.
DeRozan's got his second basket of the night. There might be more talent at the point guard position now, Craig, than there's ever been in the NBA. But who do you think sits at the top of that list?
I mean, Kevin, there's so many incredible talents. And not that I'm dodging it, but honestly, the beauty is in the eye of the beholder. It depends on what kind of tickles your fancy in terms of the point guard. If it's the ability to shoot and play without it, Steph's at the top of your lead list. But then you get a guy like Chris Paul, who I think is as good as anybody's ever been in the pick and roll. So they're just different ways to approach this game. Of course, now I forgot four or five guys that I should have added into this conversation.
It's a chance now to catch up with the fourth member of our crew, Hall of Famer David Aldridge.
Well, the league remains in love with three-pointers, but DeMar DeRozan remains true to his game. He says, if I see 100 people walking left, that doesn't mean I'm going to do the same. I see this clear path and want to stay right. Shooting threes, I feel like I'm settling. Whereas I think anytime I drive, I'm going to score or get fouled. Kevin, strokes to different folks.
Yeah, but D.A., I love that strategy. Thanks for that score. Curl. Chicago grabs the miss.
You can't look at the result of that shot. They take that whenever they get it.
But, you know, I hear you. That's a good look. But when you're that wide open, I think you got to knock it down.
Now here's Levine. He's got six. Count that one.
Zach Levine's
got six here in this quarter.
He's done a nice job, a great job, actually, of finding efficient shots here in the second. Shooting percentage always a function of the kinds of shots you get. And he's on a good roll after struggling to get in the first.
There's Embiid. And Jones pulls it down. And so it's Ball who brings the ball up for Chicago. 7-point differential. Takes it to Levine. Off the backboard. Up top, Russell. Good, and Curry gets the assist. Russell's got 5 points so far. Let's look at the energy stats, how the hustle game has been going for Philadelphia.
Boy, you have to admire their intensity in the paint defensively. I mean, really contesting and even blocking shots. Definitely a factor early.
And the other thing that's been equally as effective is the fact that they've gotten out on the fast break. A lot of points coming in transition.
Here's DeRozan after D'Angelo Russell's bucket. Misses the three, and he used the pump fake well there, but he couldn't capitalize.
And DeRozan, a free agent this past offseason, took his time to find the right fit in terms of who he would sign with, ultimately choosing Chicago in a big victory for the Bulls.
Embiid, no good.
Well, he has not been sharp this period. Seems to be a little flustered out there, too.
Ball dishes to DeRozan. Outside, Jones. Jones with the screen on Russell. Kicks it out to Jones. Oh, good with the triple. The 76ers leading by 9. Green passes to Russell. Puts the move on. No good. Now Chicago takes it the other way.
This shot's just, it's not there right now with this team leading. Perhaps, you know, let's focus on some other areas of the game.
Green dishes to Kerr. At the top of the key, Embiid. 76ers moving the ball around. It's Russell with the drive. Nice D from DeRozan. Bulls trail by 9. To the middle. And DeRozan throws it down.
DeRozan.
And when Ball has the ball, it's in good hands. He can run the offense, no doubt.
Timeout call for the 76ers. how when Lonzo Ball entered the league in 2017, Greg, there were major questions about his shooting. And he struggled, of course, during his rookie year.
And shooting 30% from deep down to 50% at the line. But credit to Lonzo. He's put major work into his stroke, getting that free throw percentage to over 75% during his fourth year in the league. And his three-point numbers, they've also improved greatly.
Back, his points per game really underscored the fact that he never took a game off. I mean, one special performance after another all season long.
Russell against Ball. Russell inside. In the way up off the glass. Russell's got his third basket of the night.
And he is really coming to life here after a slow start in that first quarter.
That's a floater go. It's hauled in by the 76ers. Outside Green. And the foul on Patrick Williams.
Patrick Williams.
That is his first foul of the game.
First personal foul.
Checked in for Philadelphia.
First team foul.
And here's Russell. He had a 12-point outing in their last game against Portland. Williams with the ball. He's picked up by Russell. Williams passes the ball. Back to Williams. Passes it to DeRozan. Lock at six. And it's wide right. Hits off the rim. And George Trunner with it. He'll bring it up for the Philadelphia 76ers. With a 9-point lead. Out to Russell. And Bede with a screen on Levine. With the ball. No points in the game yet for him. Here's Drummond. Open and close and
in. I mean, the number of points they've scored in the paint already is high.
Bulls trail by 11. They've been struggling here on offense.
Yeah, a bit of a dry spell for sure.
And that one drops. Philadelphia's gone 1-2 on three-pointers here in the second quarter so far. Pass to Embiid. Here's Thibel. He's guarded by Williams. Bounce pass from Drummond. Here's Embiid. And again, it's Philadelphia.
You know, as you add experience, you start to see the floor better.
That was a sweet find by Drummond.
For Chicago, they've gone 7-13 for the field since the start of the second. Outside, Levine. Johnson hits to Levine. Shoots over Curry. Rebound by the 76ers. Drummond's got rebound number 8 now on the night. Embiid with a screen on Ball. And there's the pass to Embiid. Thibel on the wing. Embiid the screen. And that one's good. Freiburg's got the lead up to 13 now for the 76ers.
Well, we've seen that movie a few times, haven't we? An easy bucket in the paint.
Well, listless and lifeless at the defensive end. I mean, especially inside. They've really got to pick up that interior defense.
Ball, the pass to Johnson. Outside DeRozan. On deep.
Well, I tell you what, his teammates love seeing this. So do I. I mean, Russell is able to block a shot. That's a big bonus.
Pass to Drummond. Now here's Embiid. Some nice ball movement here by the 76ers. And it's Russell missing. Bulls trail by 13. Passes it to Ball. Johnson up top, guarded by Embiid. Johnson dishes to Williams. Back to Johnson. Good, and it's Williams who picks up the assist.
Assist from
Johnson's got his second bucket of the night.
Man, giving up some inches inside, but makes up for it.
For the Sixers.
You know, with that size difference, that's not an easy shot. I mean, I don't care how close to the rim he is, that's a tough shot.
He's good. All right, coming up to the court right now, it's your Sixers, Ted T.
The 76ers. Harris is checked in for Matisse Thybulle. Shake Milton comes in for Curry, and Maxey's subbed in for Russell. Then for the Bulls, Tony Bradley's checked in for Elise Johnson. Kobe White comes in for DeMar DeRozan, and it's Alex Caruso in for Ball. Passes to Embiid. Embiid with the screen on White. Here's Milton. And he overshot that one, missing. And Caruso's got the ball here for the Chicago Bulls. They trail by 11. Outside Brent. And the call will be against Harris. That is his first foul of the game.
That's his first personal foul. First team foul.
Bradley is screen on Harris. It's Williams with the drive. 8 feet away. That one wide left.
Now, there's an example of good defense beating good offense.
And there's the drive. Here's Milton. Target from three-point range. Bulls trail by 11. Now Levine. 8 points for him. This one for three. Gets it to drop, and now he's shooting at a 5-for-8 clip. Philadelphia's gone 1-for-4 from three-point range in the second. Not a whole lot dropping out there for him. Maxey passes to Harris. And B with a screen to Levine. Levine against Harris. Six to shoot. Drummond the screen. Here's Milton. The putback. And Drummond is right there. Drummond's got 10.
Guys,
guys, his consistency in terms of shooting has really helped them seize control.
Outside, White. Bradley sends the pick for White. And it's Philadelphia with the rebound. Embiid's got his fifth rebound in this one. Here's Milton. Out to Harris. Three-pointer. And the 76ers get it back. And it's Drummond missing. Bulls trail by 10. Over in the corner, White. Pass to Levine. And Joel Embiid throws it down. Embiid's got six rebounds now in the game. In the basket, Embiid. Score the basket. It's number six for him this game. 6 for 9, 67% shooting.
Man, nice to see how Embiid operates in the pick and roll. Knows how to set hard screen as well as where and when to roll.
Light the pass to Bradley. Over Drummond. Bradley can't get it to go. We've got a 9-second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. On the wing, Milton. No good there. Nice tee from Levine.
Boy, just cannot buy a bucket, guys. I tell you what, that's a painful quarter for him, and it's painful for me to watch, too.
Shoots from 14. No good, shot missing. And so it's Philadelphia enjoying a 12-point lead as they talk things over during the break. They've been playing some inspired defense, giving a very few easy points. And now let's catch up with David Aldridge, who's standing by from the sideline. All right, Dave.
Hey, Kevin, thank you. Joel, an early lead and a lot to like in the performance thus far. Would you agree?
Oh, I thought we played great. Defensively, I know that I had someone behind me. If I made a mistake, I was going to protect the rim. I thought we did great.
We know the adjustments are coming, and we'll see who takes advantage. Thanks. Back to you, Kevin.
Thanks so much, David. And we'll step away briefly, but get you right back out here for the start of the third quarter after this break.
Hey, folks. Thanks for joining us. It would be an understatement to say it's been a great half for the Philadelphia 76ers.
You guys know I appreciate when a team takes a commitment to attack in the painted area. When you get those high percentage looks, good things tend to happen. That's how they built this lead.
And looking at the players of the month, here are the winners from each conference. Over in the East, Joel Embiid.
The big man, Joel Embiid. He's so patient with his moves and decision-making now. His combination of size and feet work are incredible. He has that Hakeem Olajuwon gene. Looking for him to win this award many more times to come.
And that about does it for us. Now for the good stuff as we get set to resume the second half.
What? We're not any good?
Ernie, we've been friends since 1989, but I resent that, Ernie.
We'll settle it off camera, one at a time. You first, Jet.
I'm sorry.
I was just playing, Ernie.
And with a big gap on the scoreboard, the second half begins with very different goals for these teams. One side trying to mount a comeback, one side trying to protect their lead. Joel Embiid has been sensational.
Man, he's been running wild on them through that first half. Absolute dynamite on offense.
And you know what? I'll be interested to see just how much he's got left in the tank. That first half had to take a lot out of him.
And as we dive into the second half, we'll find out if the next two quarters are any different from the first two. So far, it has been a runaway. Out on the block, it's Harris and Embiid. Outside, the wings are Curry and Green. And it's Russell in at the point guard. That's the group on the floor for Philadelphia. Levine feeling it out of it. Over Green. Levine's shot is off.
They have been bored and dominant in this game. That's definitely been a factor in crafting this huge lead.
And it's been a well-rounded performance. I mean, strong rebounding has certainly been at the center of it, but it's been good on a number of levels.
Now, here is Russell. Zach LaVine unable to get his last shot to go. Curry, wide open. Off the mark there with the three-point shot. And so it's Ball with it. He brings it up for the Bulls. A 12-point game. And the latest wrinkle in Seth Curry's game, creating for others with consistency.
And he's taking time with his reads, letting the defense commit, then making his move. All part of that maturation process.
And the shot goes in.
It's a great move, and he catches the defense completely off guard.
Yeah, if that's a harbinger of things to come, he's looking at having a very big second half.
Now here's Embiid. He's got 12. The pass to Ball. Just over a minute and a half played here in the third. DeRozan finds LaVine. Bradley is screen on Russell. There's LaVine. No good there, and that would have cut it to single digits. Philadelphia leading by 10. Outside Russell. Pass to Curry. Here's Harris. And a great assist by Curry as that one goes in. Curry's got 4 assists now tonight. For Chicago, they've got just one of their first 4 shots to fall since coming up the lock to break. LaVine against Green. That shot is off. Good D by Embiid. The 76ers shooting 43% for the game. Green dishes to Harris. Russell passes to Harris. Embiid with a screen on Johnson. And then it's Harris. A deep 3-point range. That shot, no good. And Chicago will go the other way with the ball. DeRozan against Curry. Now, here's DeRozan. 8 points for him. Looking to get it going. And the dunk by DeRozan.
You know, they'll put the ball in DeRozan's hands and run the pick and roll all day long. He's phenomenal at getting good shots in that set.
Who wants a t-shirt? Make the noise, everybody. Pass your sensor.
Put up about 19 points per, 6 rebounds and 3 assists. And you talk about guys who just have a nose for putting up points. He is one of them.
Yeah, he sure is. And he rarely has back-to-back bad games. If he has an off night, he usually follows that up with a big night.
And now we're 3 minutes into the third quarter of play. Embiid with a screen on Ball. Inside. He's guarded by Johnson. Here's Embiid. 5 to shoot. And the rejection by Bradley. Outside DeRozan. Giannis there with a chance to cut the lead to single digits.
Just a solid performance on the interior. The rebounding has been off the charts.
Yeah, you look across the board, it's actually sizing up, shaping up to be a great game. I mean, strong performances throughout, and they've really been strong on the glass.
Now here's DeRozan. He's got 10. The shot, no good. Levine against Curry. Pass to Russell. Shoots over Ball. Another miss by Philadelphia.
You know, you'd like to see a little more effort there defensively, but maybe they wanted him to take that shot, baited him into it.
Bradley is screened on Harris. Levine with it, and Curry picks him up defensively. That's good. The 76ers lead is cut down now to just 8 points with the basket from Levine. And it's Curry with the ball, bringing it up for the 76ers. Their defense has only allowed 6 points in the second half. Now, here's Russell. He's got 7. Outside for Curry. Connects from three-point range. Curry's got his first bucket of the game, and he's on the board for 3.
Chicago, timeout call.
All right, man, it's T-shirt time. We got 3 shirts.
Checked in for Joel Embiid. Then for the Bulls, Derrick Jones, he's checked in for Johnson. And it's wide in for Levine. Bulls trail by 11. There's a screen. Here's White. Green with the rebound. Green's got 4 rebounds in this game.
It's a +5 advantage for them.
Terrific read on the part of Russell that time. Scanned the court, spotting the open man, and then whipped it there for an easy dunk.
And keeping us updated from the sideline, let's swing it over to David Aldridge.
Thank you, Kevin. As NBA revenues climb into the tens of billions of dollars, teams have even more resources to compete. Tony staffs are growing, more coaches, trainers, and specialists, so general managers have more to manage than ever. Generally, the best organizations are those that effectively collaborate and communicate across the board. Kevin?
And DA, as we know, that's always been the case. Thank you. That free throw, no good. And Philadelphia making a change here. Drummond's checked in. Second free throw, good. Philadelphia leading by 12. Drummond sets the screen for Russell. And it's off from 3-point range. White. He's still scoreless so far in this one. He kicks to DeRozan. Shot clock at 6. To the paint and stolen by Drummond. Last break, Philadelphia. Curry passes to Harris and slam dunk by Harris.
Well, he sure is a talented combo forward with terrific feel for the game. Harris can score in bunches.
If you look at the leaders in rebounding, it's almost a sure thing that Drummond's name is going to be near the top of that list. That's the kind of impact on the boards he's made over his career.
Curry dishes to Harris. Good, and Curry gets the assist. 14 points for Tobias Harris.
Oh, great ball there.
Bulls trail by 16. Ball feeling it out a bit. Bradley is screen on Russell. Outside DeRozan. Trying to break that ice cold streak. DeRozan throws it down hard.
Well, I tell you what, DeRozan really packs a punch now. He's an explosive athlete with really good strength. I mean, he's got great size for a backcourt dominant scorer.
And they're bringing you up close and personal at the AT&T 5G Slam Jam. And Greg, when it comes to players who've led the league in rebounding, very few have done it as many times as Drummond.
And the guys that have done it more than twice, like Andre, I've got some good news for him. Every one of them is either in the Hall of Fame or soon will be.
Now here's DeRozan. After D'Angelo Russell's miss, and Bradley gets it to go.
Assisted.
DeRozan sizing up the situation and making the right read. That's basketball savvy. We call that hoops sense.
Russell with it. Now guarded by Bradley. And Drummond kicks to Curry. Philadelphia moving the ball. It's good from long range. This has got 10 points in the game.
How many times have we seen a possession like that from them today? Ending with the basket, coming off a pretty pass.
Well, when you look at the assist totals, heck, they've been clearly the better team.
Matisse.
And there's the call on Matisse Thybulle. That is his first foul of the game. Some changes for Philadelphia. Jake Milton comes in for Matisse Thybulle. And Maxey subbed in for Curry. Chicago also making some changes. Williams comes in for DeMar DeRozan. And it's Alex Caruso in for Ball. Here's Caruso. He's gotten some minutes, but nothing on the board yet. To the inside. Bradley. And he takes it in for the layup off a very nice feed.
How about how he sets his man up there, runs him right into the screen, and then gets it easy.
Outside Russell. Caruso grabs the miss. Caruso's got 5 rebounds tonight. Williams, a screen on Russell. Caruso, the pass to Williams. And it's Williams finishing it off.
Alex Caruso
to the 10, trying to get his guys going.
Hard not to get motivated, GA, right when your teammate makes that kind of play.
You know, when you're looking to close the gap, you need guys who will take it upon themselves to step up, take the initiative, and make something happen.
Here's Caruso. Tobias Harris picking up that last basket. And it's sent back by Drummond. Outside Russell. Drummond sets the screen for Russell. Drummond trying to get himself free. Russell, no luck. And Caruso's got the ball here for the Chicago Bulls. Trailing by 13. Driving inside. Nice deal from Russell. Philadelphia has gone 2 of 5 with a 3-point shot since coming out of the break. Fires for 3. It's good. Nice touch there from Maxey. Maxey's got himself going with the triple, his first basket of the game. To the paint. And White slams it in.
And at 6'5", White more than capable athletically, like the aggressive you said.
Drummond the screen, and there's the foul.
Caruso.
Alex Caruso. That's his first foul.
That's a tough call right there, and really a tough break for the beat.
No problem for me with that call. I mean, he was still sliding right there.
And that was another look at the aggressive D that led to the Mobile One block.
And this is how you protect and grow a lead, by making a huge effort on that end of the floor.
action. Drummond with a screen on Williams. Russell pushes to Drummond. And so it looks like the 76ers will retain possession of the ball. And now a chance to see what's coming up for the Philadelphia 76ers. On Thursday, I'll be facing off against DeMarcus Cousins and the Detroit Pistons. And then on Saturday, they'll be matching up against DeMar DeRozan and the Chicago Bulls. Here's Milton. Again, Philadelphia.
Even with the big lead, he remains focused on the task at hand.
Yeah, and you know, that is some shaky and shoddy defensive work. They got to tighten it up.
Now, here's Brent. He's got seven. Here's White. Maxie grabs the miss.
Yeah, that's another miss. They're behind in this game, largely because he shot so poorly.
Kicks it to Russell, beyond the arc. Rebound by the Bulls. Pass to Caruso. There's the feed to Bradley. There's 1:38 left to play in the third. There's Williams, and it's slammed in by Williams.
And cutting into the lead with the big one-hand throwdown.
That's how you get your team back into it.
That might indeed ignite a spark in this team.
Here's Maxey. No good that time. And it's Chicago the other way. White the pass to Caruso. 109 left in the third quarter. Back to White. From deep. Andre Drummond grabs the miss. Drummond's got his 16th rebound on the night. Maxey passes to Russell. Harris outside. Over Jones. And the rejection by Bradley. Outside Williams. There's the pass to Caruso. Jones sets the pick for White. Here's the teardrop. Bradley kicks to Williams. Just 5 to shoot. Over Russell. They get it again. Count it. And the Philadelphia lead has been cut down now to just 12 points with the basket from Bradley.
Yeah, how about the purpose with which he's crashing the backboards right now? Some hard-earned second-chance points.
And here's Russell. Into the lane. Over Williams. Tobias Harris, he's feeling it tonight and has been the driving force for Philadelphia. He got the double digits for the quarter with 10 points total. Right back after this break. Let's go back to a play from earlier as we show you our State Farm assist of the game.
Yeah, terrific, unselfish play right here. Set up his teammate, and how about the setup this way?
Yeah, and as a two-guard, he's typically not a reluctant shooter, so it's really nice to see him orchestrating for a teammate instead.
It's the fourth quarter.
And we reach the fourth quarter of the game that may be already out of hand. Leading by 12. So for Chicago right now, Michael Levine on the wing. Bradley is out there with Johnson, and it's Ball in at the point. And Chicago shoot just 34% from the floor. He feeds it to Levine. Six on the shot clock. Here's Ball with the three. It's hauled in by the 76ers. Drummond's got rebound number 17, if you can believe that. Maxey. Ball with the rebound.
You know what? They're winning, though, despite the fact that he has just been really
good. Levine against Drummond. Now here's Levine. Defense is right there. Drummond with a screen on Levine. Out to the right wing. open. Sinks the triple. Embiid's got the first basket as we get going in the fourth for the 76ers. And an important part of every team's game, a look at the hustle stats for Philadelphia.
You know, block shots, guys, a clear indicator on the stat sheet of their excellent defense. I mean, leaving them no room to get off any shots.
And also, how about the points they've got in transition or on the fast break tonight? That's been a huge factor as well.
Here's Green following the basket by Lonzo Ball. Green passes to Embiid. Good, and it's Green picking up the assist. And the 76ers lead by 15.
And they call him Dancing Danny Green, and you can see why. Excellent offensive instincts there.
Ball gets to Levine. Goes up the baseline. And misses it off the right side of the rim. The 76ers leading by 15. Now, here's Maxey. There's Embiid. That's down the hatch. That's one more to his total. That's 9 for 15 shooting.
You know, every year Embiid seems to kick this point up just a notch. I think he realizes how dominant he can be.
Levine against Green. Looking to end his cold spell. Levine's shot is up. The 76ers have gone 3-5 here in the fourth quarter. Pretty good numbers coming out of the break. And out of bounds as the Bulls gain possession.
Chicago ball.
Curry's checked in for the 76ers.
Bulls substitution.
DeMar DeRozan, he's checked in for Chicago. Bulls trail by 17. Outside, Ball. On the wing, Levine. Curry against White. And stolen by Drummond. Over in the corner, Green launches it. Rebound by the Bulls. Jackson has got his fifth rebound in this one. White inside. Curry meets him. And comes up down the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here.
That's his first
more
personal foul.
First team foul. White has worked hard on his playmaking ability.
At the line for the Bulls, Kobe White. Two shots.
Oh, take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
And that one falls for White.
The athleticism and blinding speed White possesses is impressive. This guy plays with a lot of moxie.
And both free throws good for White. And now that we've gotten a taste of it, Greg, what do you think of the play-in tournament?
I love it. I mean, it definitely has some pros and cons, and you want to keep as many teams as possible engaged down the stretch, but it's a long season, and for some teams, it just got a little bit long.
Some nice ball movement here by the 76ers. Four on the clock. The 76ers need to get off a shot. Knocks down the three ball. And Beans got 10 points in just a second.
It's been this way since halftime. Tremendous production from beyond the arc.
Boy, it's been a three-point barrage. They came out gunning and have not stopped.
Now here's Levine. Here's DeRozan. And it's Joel Embiid with the rebound. Embiid's got double-digit rebounds now in the game. Outside Curry. Again, Johnson with the block to the middle. Here's Ball, and Ball slides it in.
You know, that's a veteran play. DeRozan stays open to all possibilities. That's seeing the game in front of him. Excellent find.
Now, here's Maxey. Shoots over ball. And it's off the back rim. No good.
You know, he hasn't contributed well scoring the ball, but obviously his teammates have.
Feeds it to Johnson. Johnson with a screen on Drummond. And there's the call on Andre Drummond.
Andre Drummond.
That's his first foul.
That's his first
Bulls making a switch
foul.
Here. Bradley's check in.
Foul. Coming onto the floor for the Bulls, Tony Bradley.
DeRozan on the wing, defended by Drummond. Over Drummond. DeRozan's shot is off.
Their game plan needs to change if they're going to get out of this hole, because he is just not there offensively.
Green passes to Maxey. He dishes it to Kerr. Passes it to Embiid. Five on the clock. Over Johnson. Embiid, the bucket on the assist by Kerr. Curry's got assist number 7 for him tonight. Bulls trail by 18. Outside, ball. Bradley is screen on Green. Got it. Nice one there from Levine.
Levine, a primetime threat to knock down those mid-range jumpers.
Here's Maxey. Screen on ball. And the dunk by Embiid.
The finish was nice, but the set was better.
Yeah, GA, the pick working to full effect. He pulled his gun.
And, you know, not enough help from the defense there to compensate. He gets a clean look. And that's exactly how you draw
all right,
it up.
Coming out to the court right now, the Sixers, Embiid.
Tonight, this kind of performance only cements his status as a fan favorite. And it's DeRozan with the ball for the Chicago Bulls. It's an 18-point game. Johnson sets the screen for DeRozan. Over Green. And again, Chicago. No good. Philadelphia has gotten off four three-pointers. turnovers in the final quarter, and two of them have fallen. Curry passes it to Embiid. And he makes in the layup. Embiid's got 16 here in the second half.
DeRozan. Bradley is screen on Green. Six to shoot. A 10-footer. Ball with the bucket.
Lonzo Ball.
Ball's got six here in this quarter.
A tough first half, but it's been a different story here since the break.
Russell against Ball. Russell dishes to Green. Embiid sets the pick for Harris. And the 76ers take on two more.
Pretty much all of their buckets coming from inside the paint now.
Ball kicks to Johnson. Pass to Levine for the three. It's hauled in by the 76ers. Russell left side. Curry passes to Russell. Yes, that goes in.
The defense not putting up any fight. They've allowed 10 straight points in the paint.
That's not the kind of streak you want to be part of defensively. Tighten it up, fellas.
Now, here's Ball. And there's the call on Curry. That'll be his second foul of the game. And Greg, a lot of new head coaches stepping into this season. How does a first-year coach come in and
win over a wire?
I mean, Kevin, that's a great question. I think there's a combination of confidence and humility that one has to have. And I think, believe it or not, the most important trait, you got to be consistent. Your message cannot waver. It cannot fluctuate. That's one way that you will lose a locker room.
Here's Russell. The pass to Harris. He takes it in. Can't hit that one. And it's Chicago the other way. Outside, Ball. Johnson. That falls. Nice feed that time from Ball.
Assisted by
Ball's got four assists in the game.
And he can time his passes so perfectly. Wow, what an assist.
Now, here is Russell, and the call will be against Alize Johnson.
Alize Johnson.
That is his first foul of the game.
First personal foul. First team foul.
Russell passes to Drummond. Dishes it to Harris. Outside for Curry. They double-team Curry. Four on the shot clock. Here's Green. And the call will be against Alize Johnson.
Alize Johnson.
That's foul number two for him.
That's his second personal foul. Second team foul.
On the wing, Harris. Ball against Russell. Shot clock at five. Green passes to Harris. For Johnson, Harris misses.
And it's still a rare sight to see rebound numbers like the ones he's had tonight.
Boy, he has put in some major work. He's earning his pay, for sure.
Now, here's Bradley. Johnson with a screen on Green. DeRozan with it. Picked up by Harris. Offensive rebound. DeRozan. That's good.
DeRozan.
You got to get a body on DeMar DeRozan because if you don't, his size and athleticism will allow him to hurt you on the glass.
Russell against Ball. Russell passes to Harris. Drummond with a screen on Johnson. Inside.
2 minutes remaining in the game.
Ball with the rebound. Ball's got rebound number five here tonight. DeRozan in the corner. Curry against Levine. Johnson sets the screen for Levine. Right in the lane. And Levine with the slam.
And you can see why LaVine's been a hard, tough out in the slam dunk contest. Has a natural ability to entertain the audience, and that bounce and athleticism certainly doesn't hurt either.
Now here's Drummond. And he can't stop this drought. Another miss.
And tonight's battle is going to end with a very clear winner, leaving nothing to chance. Impressive win for Philadelphia.
The blocking really turned things into their favor this time.
Great timing, anticipation, and they got the blocks, and that definitely changed the momentum of this game.
And with this effort tonight, grabbing their eighth win of the year.
And asserting themselves up front here, guys. They'll be taking the front end of a four-game season series between these two. They've got to feel good about getting the upper hand tonight against the Bulls.
And what a tremendous standout performance it was for Joel Embiid.
And with the way he came out energized on the defensive end in particular, getting a hand on a lot of shots, that really got them rolling. And he's been a force on the glass all game long.
Yeah, I love the way he's fighting through box outs, using his elbows. I mean, he's doing whatever it takes.
And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line.
Lonzo Ball picks one up.
You know, with Drummond's free throw history, teams aren't afraid to get physical with him inside. I mean, they'll send him to the line before they give him an easy run.
Andre Drummond taking two shots.
Two shots. Relax on the first.
Free throw, good. Drummond
selected ninth overall in the 2012 draft. Drummond's carved out a nice NBA career for himself.
Catching up on the changes for Philadelphia, Shake Milton comes in for Seth Curry, and Maxey subbed in for D'Angelo Russell. The Bulls also changing it up. Derek Jones, he's checked in for Elise Johnson. Williams comes in for DeMar DeRozan, and it's Alex Caruso in for LaVine. Ball with a wide open look. Hits it from three-point range.
I really think it's important that shot becomes part of Ball's arsenal. He's got to get comfortable knocking down the three-point shot.
Now, here's Maxey. He's guarded closely. Lays it up off the glass. And the 76ers lead by 16.
They made the most of their opportunities, looking comfortable and locked in throughout the night.
Boy, they've given their fans plenty to cheer about, that's for sure. Effort, skill, coaching, you name it, they've done it.
So it's the 76ers winning this one easily. They poured it out tonight. Dominique showing in front of a crowd that loved every minute of it.
And, you know, this game could really be a defining one for what they can do and what they are playing at their best. I mean, being here at home, no doubt helps, and the execution was flawless.
And now, let's check in with David Aldridge reporting from the sideline for our player of the game. David, take it away.
Thanks very much, Seth. Satisfying home win. What does the support feel like in front of these fans?
Oh, it's great. Great home court. They bring that energy every game, even when we're struggling. So, I mean, it's much appreciated, and it felt good to get this win for them.
It was a team effort and a crowd effort as well. Congrats. Back to you.
All right, David, thank you. And that'll wrap it up, folks. For David Aldridge, Greg Anthony, and Clark Kellogg, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for being with us. So long, everyone.